Welcome to another video tutorial on PLC programming. In today's session, we will learn how we can change and control the duty cycles of the pumps or motors using PLC programming logic. Before starting today's session, I would request you guys to please subscribe this channel and press the bell icon for more upcoming video tutorials. Let's suppose we have three pumps. Pump number 1, pump number 2, and pump number 3. When we start the pumps, only pump number 1 and pump number 2 should turn on, and the pump number 3 should remain standby. In the next cycle, the pump number 3 and pump number 1 should turn on, and pump number 2 should remain standby or off. In the next cycle, the pump number 2 and pump number 3 should turn on, and pump number 1 should remain standby. So this is the duty cycle sequence which we will be trying to make today in the PLC program. The pump number 1, 2 and 3 are connected at Q0.0, Q0.1 and Q0.2 outputs of the PLC respectively. Similarly, start and stop push buttons are connected at I0.0 and 0.1 inputs of the PLC. Now let's go to the Cymatic Manager software, and there we will be writing the ladder logic for the today's tutorial. First of all, we will insert a network here, and in this network we will insert an NO contact, and we will assign it I0.0, which is our start push button. So whenever we press the start push button, we have to hold on a memory bit M0.0, which is start bit. To hold on, we will just simply insert a branch here, NO contact, and we will assign it same M0.0 and connect a branch here. So whenever the start bit is on, it will get light through its own NO contact. Now to turn off this start bit, we will use the stop push button. So we will insert an NC contact here, and we will assign it I0.1, which is our stop push button. We will insert another network here, and in this network we will count how many times we have turned on the memory bit M0.0. For this, we will insert an NO contact, and we will assign it M0.0. The next thing is that we will insert a positive edge detection coil. So this is our positive edge detection coil. We will double click on it, and we will assign it a bit, which is M0.0. Next, we will insert an add integer function. So as you can see that this add integer function has two inputs and one output. Whatever the values we enter here in input 1 and input 2, this function will add these two values, and a result will be saved in this address, output address. So in the input 1, we will write here MB20. MB20 means memory by 20. In input 2, we will enter 1. And in the output, we will enter here again MB20. So this byte is same as of this input 1. Initially, the value of the MB20 will be 0. Whenever the start bit is on, it will add 0 plus 1 equals to 1. And as this memory byte 20 is same here, so 1 will come here. So next time when we turn on the start bit, 1 plus 1 equals to 2, and this 2 will come here. And whenever next time we turn on this start bit, 2 plus 1 equals to 3. So basically this function is just keep on adding how many times we have turned on this start bit. So we will insert another network here, and in this network we will write the logic to reset this value of the MB20 to 0. So to reset the value of the memory by 20 to 0, we will use NO contact of stop push button, which is I0.1. So next we will use a negative edge detection coil here, and we will write here M2.1 bit, we have to use here comparator instruction. So we will go to the comparator and we will insert here greater than equal to instruction. So this compare instruction will compare the values of the two inputs. The first input will be MB20 and the second we will write here 3. So whenever the value of the MB20 is greater or equal to 3, this compare instruction will get activated. So we will use here the move instruction and we will input here 0 and the output will be MB20. So whenever the value is greater or equal to 3, this move instruction will move 0 into this MB20 byte. So it will again make the value of this MB20 to 0. As you can see that up till now we have written the logic in such a way that we have created a counter here. So first time when we turn on this start bit, the MB20 value will be 1. And second time when we turn on this start bit, the MB20 byte value will be equal to 2. Third time when we turn on this start bit, the MB20 value will be equal to 3. And whenever the value is equal to 3 and we are going to turn off the pump by pressing the stop push button on the negative edge, it will reset the value of the MB20 to 0. So in the next network, we will use the value of this MB20 byte to turn on the pump and change the duty cycle of these pumps. So now let's write the logic to change the duty cycles for these pumps. For this one, we will use the bit M0.0, which is our start bit. And the next thing, we have to compare again the value of this memory by 20. But this time we will insert equal to comparator. Okay, so it will compare two values and it will only get activated whenever the two values are equal to each other. So we will write here MB20 at the first input and in the second input we will write 1. So whenever the value of the MB20 is equal to 1, so here we will insert the bit M3.1. Now this bit will indicate that our current count is 1. Next we will insert a branch here and we will use the same comparison operation here and we will compare it with the two. Now the MB20, whenever the value in the MB20 is equal to the 2, we will activate a coil here which is M3.2. Now this will indicate that we have pressed the start push button 2 times. Next we will insert another branch here and we will use the comparison instruction here. This time we will compare the MB20 with the value 3. So whenever the count inside the MB20 data register is equal to 3, it will activate a bit which is M3.3 and this bit will indicate that we have pressed or started the motors 3rd time. We will insert another network here which is network number 5 and in this network we will write the logic to start the pump number 1. So as we have discussed earlier that whenever the count is 1, we should start the pump number 1 and the pump number 2. So simply we can do here, we will insert a normal open contact of M3.1 and whenever this bit is closed, we will start the Q0.0 which is pump number 1. Okay, we will insert another network here which is network number 6 and in this network we will write the logic to start the pump number 2. So whenever the count is 1, we should also have to start the pump number 2 as well. So we will insert our NO contact here and we will start Q0.1 with this contact.
So whenever the count is 1, it will start the pump number 1 and the pump number 2. Now, whenever the count is 2, we have to start the pump number 2 and the pump number 3 as well. So what we will do, we will insert a parallel contact here, and we will insert here M3.2. This will indicate that the count is 2, and whenever the count is 2, it will also start the pump number 2. Now, we will insert another network here, and this network will having the logic to start the pump number 3. So to start the pump number 3, we will insert an NO contact of M3.2, and we can start Q0.2, which is pump number 3. Now, whenever the count is 2, we have to stop the pump number 1. So to do this, we will insert a NC contact here for the M3.2 bit. So whenever the pump number 2 and pump number 3 is running, it will turn off the pump number 1. The next thing we want to do here is that whenever the count bit 3 is on, we have to turn on this Q0.0 and Q0.2, which is pump number 1 and pump number 3. So we will insert a parallel contact here for the bit M3.3, and we will connect it here. So now what it will do, whenever this bit is on, it will start the Q0.0 pump here, and we will insert another branch here, NO contact of M3.3, and we will connect it here in the parallel. Now when this bit is on, it will start the Q0.0 and Q0.2. But another thing we have to do here is that whenever this bit is on, we should stop this pump. So to stop this pump, we will insert a NC contact of M3.3 bit. So whenever the count is 3 and this bit is on, it will start pump number 1, pump number 3, and it will turn off the pump number 2. Okay, now our logic is ready, and we will be going to upload this program into the PLC and monitor the ladder logic and see how does it works. And as we turn on the start push button I0.0, it will turn on the M0.0 start bit. And right now, the count in the MB20 data register is 1. And if we see in the network number 4, you can see that the MB20 data register value is 1 and the count bit 1 M3.1 bit is turned on. And it has turned on the two pumps, which are pump number 1 and pump number 2, Q0.0 and Q0.1. And as we turn off the pumps by pressing the stop push button, okay, we now turn on again I0.0 start push button. You can see that right now the count in the MB20 data register is equal to 2. Count bit, which is M3.2, is also turned on. And right now the pump number 2 and pump number 3 are on, which are outputs Q0.1 and Q0.2. Now again, if we turn off our pumps and start again by pressing I0.0, you can see that right now the count is 3. As this bit M3.3 is on in the two networks, network number 7 and network number 5, it has turned on the pump number 1, Q0.0, and the pump number 3, Q0.2, which is our as per our requirement. Or now, right now the count is 3 and we have to reset this count to the 0. So how it will become 0, as we have discussed earlier, that whenever the count is equal to 3 and we are going to press the start push button, at the negative edge of the start push button, it will move 0 in the MB20 data register and it will reset all the logic, and we will be good to start again the cycle of the pumps. So right now, if we turn off, as you can see that as we press the stop push button, it has moved the value 0 into the MB20 data register. And all the logic is now reset to zero, and our pumps are again ready to start from the cycle number one. And if we turn on the start push button I0.0, as you can see that the count is one and pump number one and pump number two are on. Now we stop the pumps and start again. As you can see that this time the count bit two is on and the pump number two and pump number three are on. We will stop again the pumps, start again. Right now Q0.0 and 0.2 outputs for pump number one and pump number three are on. So these three pumps are changing their duty cycles as per our requirement, which is our target for the today's tutorial. I hope you have got some understanding how to control the duty cycles of the motors. If you like today's tutorial, please do share, like and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for more upcoming video tutorials. Till next time, take care and goodbye.